Hello everyone, this is another lesson. Remember I told you that I was going to upload some videos explaining the coming lessons. Remember to take notes and to ask me if you have any questions concerning what I'm about to teach. And then we can discuss that in the online sessions, okay? So let's begin. In this lesson, which is 4.2, the objectives are to use estar and I to talk about objects found in the dining room and a kitchen. Remember that we studied estar and I in the previous lesson concerning the parts of a house. Today we will be talking about more objects and parts of a house and new vocabulary and practice these two verbs. So let's begin. So two important rooms in the house are the kitchen and the dining room. And ambas, they give us some examples of kitchens and dining rooms. What kitchen style most looks like yours? I will show you three pictures of kitchen styles. And you will tell me which one is more like yours. They are really beautiful. Look at this one. Wow. It's beautiful. Is it like yours? Not like mine, definitely. What about this one? Also beautiful. Simpler, but beautiful. And number three is this one, which is red and silver. Okay. Just let me know which one is best for you. And these three pictures are concerning kitchen. And kitchen in Spanish is cocina. I will write here the name. Cocina. Okay? Cocina. 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 Okay, now, dining room. How do we call the dining room? Well, comedor. Sometimes kitchen and dining rooms are together. Let's see the styles that they prepare for us. Comedor. Comedor. Beautiful. Comedor. Comedor. So which one is just like yours? Mm-hmm. Okay, the next step is here. The kitchen and the dining room have items that we will study today. So different things like the microwave and the stove and things like that. La casa tiene diferentes cuartos, different rooms. So when we're talking about rooms, are all the rooms in the house, right? La sala, el comedor, la cocina, la sala familiar, el garaje, y el patio. In case you don't remember, sala is living room, comedor is dining room, cocina is kitchen, sala familiar is the family living room, this is the garage, and this is the yard. Okay? So, as a way to remember the things, en el comedor hay muchas sillas y una mesa grande. I will translate this later. En la cocina hay un refrigerador, una estufa, un horno y un lavaplatos. En la sala familiar hay dos sofás, una mesa y un televisor. En el garaje hay un carro y una bicicleta. En el patio hay una mesa, unas sillas y muchas flores. So let's see how much you can remember. In the dining room, there are. Remember I told you that I can mean there is or there are. In this case, there are. Many chairs and a big, which is grande, big table. Okay? In the kitchen, there is a refrigerator, and this is the stove. Mm-hmm. I just put the things in red, these three objects in pictures. So estufa is this. Un horno is this. Un lavaplatos is this. Okay? Horno is oven. In the family living room, there are two sofas, a table, and a TV set. In the garage, there is a car and a bicycle. In the yard, there is a table, some chairs, and many flowers. Okay, let's see the vocabulary of this lesson. As I told you before, the two main words for today is comedor and cocina. So I will read the two sentences. Remember that you have to read to repeat the sentences the way I say them. Remember in the last lesson, right? El comedor es muy grande. Please repeat that after me. El comedor es muy grande. La cocina es blanca. I know that you know these two sentences, but anyway, I will translate them. The dining room is very big, and the kitchen is white. Next is el refrigerador. Hay un refrigerador grande. La estufa es pequeña. Please repeat. Hay un refrigerador grande. There's a big refrigerator. La estufa es pequeña. The stove is small. La estufa es pequeña. Next is el horno y el microondas. In this case, you have to say the two O's. Microondas. It's like if you stand that O a little bit. Oh, microondas. Mm-hmm. El horno está caliente. The oven is hot. El microondas está en la cocina. The microwave is in the kitchen. Next is el gabinete. El gabinete. Well, here you have the plural form. Los gabinetes son modernos. The cabinets are modern. Please repeat. Los gabinetes son modernos. And next is el lavaplatos. You can read the translation here. El lavaplatos. La cocina tiene un lavaplatos. I guess you remember what this is. This is the verb to have, a conjugated. So the kitchen has a dishwasher. La cocina tiene un lavaplatos. Los gabinetes son modernos. La cocina tiene un lavaplatos. Okay? And how about one more? This is the last one. El cuarto. El cuarto. Hay cuatro cuartos en la casa. I'll let you think what this is. And el dormitorio es enorme. So, the problem is that we can call cuarto or dormitorio to the bedroom. We call this two ways. well, we can say los cuartos o las habitaciones de la casa, explaining or mentioning all the rooms in the house. But if we want to be specific, we want to say that it is the bedroom, we can say el dormitorio. Then, hay cuatro cuartos en la casa, there are four rooms in the house. El dormitorio es enorme, the bedroom is huge. Okay? Now, hay o no hay? Well, I can be followed by a singular or plural noun. You know that already. But we put no in front of I to make it negative. First, let's look at this image and answer yes or no to the statements below. Let's see. Look at the picture. Mm-hmm. One. ¿Es la cocina? ¿Sí o no? ¿Es la cocina? I guess, yes. I guess it is the kitchen. But we also have a dining room. I told you that the kitchen and the dining room could be together. So, but we can say sí. ¿Hay un refrigerador en la cocina? ¿Sí o no? Sí, here it is. ¿Hay un microondas en la cocina? Look at the picture again. Sí, here it is. ¿Hay 8 sillas en la cocina? Wow. This is the table, and here we have 4 chairs. 4 more chairs are supposed to be in this part, but we cannot see it. So I have to say no, because I can only see 4. It's up to you. For me, it's no. ¿Hay 8 sillas en la cocina? No, I can see only 4. ¿Hay lámparas en la cocina? Lámparas. Lamps. There are lamps in the kitchen. See, here. 3. ¿Hay un televisor en la cocina? Well, I cannot see any TV, so no. La cocina es grande. The kitchen is big. It is appreciation. For me, it is. So I would say yes. Sí, la cocina es grande. La cocina es azul. Definitely not. I don't see any blue here. So the kitchen is blue? No. Okay. So, ¿es la cocina? Sí. ¿Hay un refrigerador en la cocina? Sí. ¿Hay un microondas en la cocina? Sí. ¿Hay 8 sillas en la cocina? No. ¿Hay lámparas en la cocina? Sí. ¿Hay un televisor en la cocina? No. ¿La cocina es grande? Sí. ¿La cocina es azul? No. Okay. Let's continue. Let's move on. Okay. Let's take a little time to review the verb estar. Remember, this verb estar, it's another way to say or to talk about the verb be, but it is used to express location, so where are things. Then, the question is, ¿dónde está el lavaplatos? ¿Dónde están las sillas y la mesa? Remember, está for singular and están for plural. So, let's see. ¿Dónde está el lavaplatos? ¿Está en el garaje? ¿Están en el comedor? ¿Está en la sala? ¿Está en la cocina? ¿Dónde está el lavaplatos? Here. Está en la cocina. ¿Dónde están las sillas y la mesa? In this case, we're talking about plural things. Because el lavaplatos, although it ends in an S, it's singular. It's just one wash dish. So, está en la cocina. And the chairs and the table. ¿Dónde están las sillas y las mesas? Están en el comedor. This one. Okay, let's see another. ¿Dónde está el carro? Read the answers. I will read them. Está en el garaje, está en el comedor, está en la sala, está en la cocina. ¿Dónde está el carro? This one. Yes, I know that you know. Está en el garaje. ¿Dónde está el sofá? The sofa. ¿Dónde está el sofá? Think about it. Está en la sala. Muy bien, muy bien. Ok, ¿dónde está el microondas? ¿Dónde está el microondas? Read the answers. ¿Está en el garaje? No. ¿Está en el comedor? ¿Está en la sala? ¿Está en la cocina? Here. Está en la cocina. Ok. Let's continue. Look at the photos of the kitchen and dining room and see if you can name the objects. Use the verbs estar and I as you say what is in each room. Use words from the word bank to create your sentences. Let's see. Here we have a word bank. What you have to do is to create sentences saying the objects that you can find in these two pictures. Okay? So, example, hay una estufa en la cocina and las sillas están en el comedor. So you have to use I and estar as we used in the previous lesson. So here we have the two pictures, el comedor, la cocina. What kind of sentences can we make? And this is the word bank. La silla, el televisor, las lámparas, la mesa, los platos, las flores, las servilletas, los cuadros, el microondas, el refrigerador, el horno, la lámpara, la ventana, las frutas y los gabinetes. So let's see, the first picture here, I will see, okay, well, they already mentioned las sillas, so let's talk about las lámparas. Then I can say, if I'm talking about existence, I can say, hay dos lámparas en el comedor. But if I want to talk about lamps in the kitchen, hay tres. Well, not three, in fact, seven. Hay siete. Oh no, ocho. Here we have another one. Hay ocho lámparas en la cocina. And, well, no hay ventana en el comedor. I mean, ventana is window. Y no hay ventanas en la cocina. No hay ventanas en el comedor y no hay ventanas en la cocina. Las flores. No hay, sí, sí hay. Hay unas flores en el comedor. Cuadros, pictures, frame. Here, no hay cuadros en el comedor. No hay cuadros en la cocina. And so on and so forth, you can write sentences and repeat things saying I and estar like the way we did in our previous lesson. Okay? And here you have again the pictures and again the sentences. So go back to the word bank. If you don't understand the meaning of these words, look it up in a dictionary. You have dictionaries online and they are free, so you can look for the meaning of the words. And then write sentences, read them out loud, and if you want to, you can record yourself and send the recording to me. And in this way I will know if you did it correctly and I can give you feedback about this. So you have to write three sentences concerning I or estar, but here they are just mentioning estar, and here I. You can be flexible, you can write all the star sentences here and all the I sentences here, or you can mix them up. It's up to you. Okay? And I will be here. You can send me the recordings and I can give you feedback if you want to. Okay, let's move on. And here we have cross-culture comparison of homes. And here we, Marisa is talking about the things he found out in her uncle's home in Cuba. And so she's mentioning the words isla, which is island, pobre, which is poor, viejas, that means old, well, comedor, ready dining room, cocina, that already, kitchen. Estufa de gas, gas stove. This is what we use to cook in my country. And refrigerador pequeño, small refrigerator. And you will listen to Marisa on bus talking about his her experience in the island. So I wrote and I bring the script and I will be here. I will read what she said. Okay, so I will begin reading and you will have to write here the things that there are or the things that there aren't according to the reading. Hola, soy Marisa. Hoy estoy en La Habana, Cuba. Cuba es una isla muy bonita, pero muy pobre. Las casas no son muy grandes y son viejas. Yo estoy en la casa de mis tíos. Ellos viven con mis primos. La casa tiene una sala, un comedor, dos cuartos y una cocina. La casa no tiene garaje. En la sala hay un sofá, una mesa, una lámpara y un televisor. A mis tíos les gusta ver la televisión en la sala. En el comedor hay una mesa de color café que tiene cuatro sillas. En la cocina hay una estufa de gas y un refrigerador pequeño. No tienen un microondas ni un lavaplatos. En la cocina los gabinetes son blancos. A mi tío le gusta estar en la cocina y preparar comida cubana. A mí me gusta estar en la casa de mis tíos porque ellos son muy simpáticos. Okay, let's write the things that I or no I. Let's see. Think about it. Think about it and let's see what we can write. Okay, I. Let's read. Hola, soy Marisa. Hoy, today, I am in Havana, Cuba. Cuba es una isla muy bonita, pero muy pobre. Las casas no son muy grandes y son viejas. Yo estoy en la casa de mis tíos. Na, na, na. Ellos viven con mis primos. La casa tiene una sala. La casa tiene, so the house has. But I can transform that sentence with I. So, hay una sala. I can say, there is. Hay una sala. What else? Un comedor. Dos cuartos. Y una cocina. Okay, and here we have the first sentence with I. So please repeat that. And I will write the second. So, la casa no tiene garaje. Then, no. No hay un garaje. Here the first no sentence. No I. Remember that I told you that just to say to put the sentence negative, we just have to add no before I. Then en la sala hay un sofá, una mesa de patá. So here we have the other sentence from here to here with I. So en la sala, I will write en la sala at the end. Then hay un sofá, just to make it different. Hay un sofá, una mesa, una lámpara. Y un televisor. En la sala. En la sala es just like a complement of plates, and we can write that at the end. Oh, this is just so small. So here we have two sentences with I, one with no I. I think it's okay now. Okay. So, en el comedor hay una mesa de color café que tiene cuatro sillas. So this is quite a complicated sentence. You haven't seen this structure before. So in the dining room, there is a table, coffee color table, which has four chairs. This is a compound sentence, so you're not used to it yet, then you don't have to study this for now. So I will write, en el comedor hay una mesa y cuatro sillas. That's okay for now. En la cocina hay una estufa de gas y un refrigerador pequeño. Okay, this could be another sentence with I, but I don't have any other space. No tienen un microondas ni un lavaplatos. They don't have neither microwave nor a wash dishwasher. So here, no, ni, it's neither nor. You haven't studied this, but I have to explain it and to translate it. So, no hay, how would you say? No hay, no hay un microondas. No hay un microondas. And I can also say no hay un lavaplatos. And here we have the six sentences for I and no I. So we have more information here, but this is okay for now. Alright, so let's practice some comprehension questions. Marisa está en la casa de sus tíos o primos en Cuba. You have to read here again, look for the information, and say if it is this one or this one. It's tíos, right? Tíos. Marisa está en la casa de sus tíos en Cuba. No tiene o no. No tiene hay. So you can write these two verbs together. And we do have a double negative sentence in Spanish. We don't have that in English, but we do have that in Spanish. So no. No hay un garaje en casa. Hay cuatro sillas, hay ocho sillas. Let me go back. How many chairs? Cuatro. Here it is. So, hay cuatro sillas. No, no un microondas. No soy, I am not. Well, yes, I'm not a microwave. But this is not logical in this situation, so no hay un microondas. Los gabinetes son negros o blancos. Blancos. I remember that I said blancos. Sí, está muy contenta. Sí, estoy muy contenta. Well, If I think it is, estoy muy contenta. If I say está, it's like she is very happy. Estoy is like yes, I am very happy. So I think it both can be correct. Okay, let's practice with estar. I don't know if you remember this. Let's try to remember estar. Yo estoy, tú estás, ella está, ellos están, vosotros estáis, ellos están. Okay, here I just put this chart for you to remember this conjugation, right? So, ellos. Let me open this a little bit. And I will copy. Ellos están en la sala. Nosotros estamos muy ocupados. Very busy. Next. La butaca. La butaca is supposed to be an object, but we don't have it as I told you. So it's supposed to be she or he. In this case, it is she because of la. La butaca is the armchair. So, está. La butaca está en la sala familiar. And tú in the house. Tú estás. Here it is. Okay. Tú estás en la casa. And more. Here we have. So, los estudiantes. Remember that you have to think about the subject and transform in your head what this can be concerning personal pronouns. So, los estudiantes, the students, are supposed to be they, and they is ellos. Then, los estudiantes están en la clase de ciencias. Nosotras no estamos contentas, happy. We are not happy. And one more. Here it is. Yo no. That's easy because yo is just only one. Yo no estoy. But this is negative. I am not. En the garage. Ella, look at this, ella está en Cuba. Okay, more. Ustedes, think about that. Ustedes están muy enojados. Usted está, here it is, usted está en Miami. Okay, and here we have the answers. And please, I want you to read after me, sentence by sentence, and in this way you will practice pronunciation. So, listen to me and repeat after me. Ellos están en la sala. Nosotros estamos muy ocupados. La butaca está en la sala familiar. Tú estás en la casa. Los estudiantes están en la clase de ciencias. Nosotras no estamos contentas. Yo no estoy en el garaje. Garaje. 8. Ella está en Cuba. 9. Ustedes están muy enojados. 10. Usted está en Miami. Some people say Miami if they are talking in Spanish, but you can say Miami. So that's all for today. This is the second lesson, remember 4.2 of Module 4, community and part of the house. This is the second lesson. I hope you understand everything. If you don't, you know what to do. So I repeat again. Please take notes. Ask me. Record the sentences with your voice. Send them to me. And that's all for today. Nos vemos en la próxima clase. Adiós.